Very good evening to all the participants. My name is Dr. Vignesh. I'm part of the National Digital Library of India team. We are one of the co-organizers and technical support partner for this 25th PN Panikkar National Reading and Digital Reading Month celebrations, along with the Niti Aayog and the Ministry of Education, Central Board of Secondary Education. So we have been organizing a series of webinars, and we have organized at least 9 webinars so far, and this is the 10th webinar. And we are having a very communicative, very educative, very lively personality with us today. And so for a change, we used to have a lot of debate, discussion, and today we are going to have a storytelling session, especially for the young and the people who still think they are young. So age is just a number. So anyone who is interested in learning something in a joyful manner, this is a session for them. It's a very light but with serious message. Obviously, Vikram will share more about this in his session. Today's session topic is on Cloud Full of Stories, a storytelling session. And as I said, Vikram Sridhar, who is one of those very well-known storytellers and the theater practitioners in the country. So you can just go to Google and search Vikram Sridhar. You will come across plethora of videos, storytelling sessions on various sessions he conducted on the YouTube as well as on the various websites. Last year also, Vikram performed a storytelling session for us, and it was like mind-boggling, and everybody enjoyed, especially the young children. And today we requested Vikram to talk to our larger audience, who are like teachers, librarians, and the school students. So he has prepared a cloud full of stories for us today. So on behalf of the entire team, we welcome Vikram for this session. Now I request Balagopal ji to formally welcome our participants and Vikram to this session. Over to Balagopal sir. So kindly unmute your mic and then you can speak.
Mr. Vikram Sridhar, your last year's performance was excellent and everybody appreciated it. And last time I missed your session, that's why I made it a point that this time I must be with you and I must listen and I must learn from you. You are because Dr. Vignesh also told me about your art in storytelling and your vocabulary and your what you call to attract the children in these sections, etc. Anyway, you are now I have been told that you are one of the country's best storyteller. Keep it up. And we also would like to have your support and your participation in all of our series of programs relating to reading and digital reading. And not only that, some other programs also, we used to conduct a lot of webinars in some other areas of interest, because two areas we are focusing, that is knowledge economy and then green economy. These are the two areas where we are focusing. And the knowledge economy is part of the Reading Day, Reading Month celebrations. And knowledge economy, then this green economy. Green economy, we used to have deliberations on green tech, green jobs and the environment conditions, etc. There also Dr. Vikram should come out with some good stories so that youngsters can be attracted, and they should be and they have to be motivated to go to the nature, and they have to learn from the nature, and they have to protect the nature. With these words, I welcome Mr. Vikram Sridhar to this program. I'm sure that a lot of students, children, and our teachers, librarians, etc., will benefit out of this. And I'm inviting all the participants, all the panelists, and all others attending this webinar over to Dr. Vignesh. And Vignesh will give you a clear idea about this program. And Vignesh is our chief coordinator of this program, and he is the main man behind all this show. And over to Dr. Vignesh.
So I think now I would request Vikram to directly get into the show because everybody is waiting to listen to your stories. Thank you. Over to you, Vikram.
Hi, everybody. Good evening. Thanks to Vignesh sir, thanks to the Library Network, thanks to Balagopal sir. Can you all hear me and see me? So if you can hear me and see me, you all are on chat. So can you all say yes, maybe, no, little bit, 100%, 200%, beautiful. Okay. So namaste, namaskara, vanakkam, kemcho, kese ho. So wherever, whichever part of India you are, I might not speak your language, but I will speak to you from the heart. Super. So before we start, you see in India, we don't start with a story. You know what we ask the first question? Did you all have a good lunch? And if you had lunch, can you tell us what did you all have for lunch? So in the chat option, there is an option to change it from panelist to panelist and attendees. Change it to panelist and attendees so that we all can see each other's answer. So what did you all have for lunch? Did you have sambar? Did you have dal chawal? Did you have khichdi? Did you have poha? What is that? Did you have for lunch? Super. Rice and dal and tomato rice, khichdi, sambari hai, dal chawal, sambar, idli, chapati, oh nice sabji, sambar, oh rice rasam, la 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 la, chapati, oh piece veggie, oh rice and curry, nice, nice, nice. Shawarma, va va va, rice, tomato, dal, sabji, la ha ha. And that's how stories start. The yummiest stories start with a good food and a very, very happy heart. And whichever city you are in, I hope you're all comfortably sitting and listening to stories. And I'm right now sitting in a city called Chennai, and which city are you all in? Which city are you all in? Are you in Delhi, Bombay, or other cities? I'll tell you if I've come to your city. Which city are you all in? Super. Sikkim, Noida, Ludhiana, Delhi. Delhi I've come to. Vadodara I've come to. Chennai, I'm here. Jaipur, yes. Bhubaneswar, I'm not coming. I want to come. Chandigarh, yes. Mohali, I've come to. Bikaner, I've crossed Bikaner. Bhavnagar, yes. I've crossed Bhavnagar. I've not been there. Haridwar, I've been to. Mumbai, yes. Chandigarh, yes. Ahmedabad, yes. Kolkata, Ludhiana. Go, go, go. Katak, super. Rajasthan's a state. Rajasthan's a state. I want which city? Kansa city hai? Are you in Udaipur, Jodhpur, Jaipur, Jaisalmer, Bhopal? Bhopal, yes, I've been to Bhopal. I've stayed in Bhopal for a week. Gurugram, super. Punjabi, Kochi, super. Raipur, okay. So I'm going to share stories with you because you know what? You're all wonderful teachers. You're all wonderful librarians. And I can't maybe teach like you. I can't talk about books like you, but I can just tell stories. And can you all tell me how do stories start in your language? Does it start with once upon a time or ek gaon mein ek or ek oru oorle oka rozu onde ondu dinadalli? How does it start in your land? And stories, we love stories, no? Because there is, just sit back and listen with me. Super. And where do we start stories? Which city do we start stories from? What stories do we start from? So the first story I'm going to tell you is a story how I learned a little bit of Hindi. You see, I come from a land where I learned Tamil, and now I speak Kannada a little bit. But so long, long ago, very long ago, so long ago, I went to Hyderabad. Okay, and I went to Hyderabad. And what language does Hyderabad speak? What language do you think Hyderabad speak? Can you tell me? Okay, can I request all of you to be with me in the session, and so that your greetings are there, but so that we can also talk to each other. Telugu. And Telugu, super. So Hyderabad speaks Telugu. Only Telugu Hyderabad speaks, that's all. Hindi, yeah. And I wanted to go to the museums of Hyderabad. And do you know who ruled Hyderabad? I mean, saying before 1947, you know, the people who ruled Hyderabad, they had a very specific name, like Zamindars. There was a specific Sultan. There was a specific name. Nawab, yeah, the Nizams. So the Nizams were ruling Hyderabad, and I wanted to go to a museum in a Nizam school. And do you all know which is the big museum in Hyderabad? That museum that's very popular, that many people go to, you might have gone to. What's that museum, big museum in Hyderabad? And if you know that, put that into the chat. And I said, no. Everybody goes to the Salar Jung Museum. And it was crowded. And I said, I want to go to this museum, which is smaller and quieter. And we searched, Googled, and somebody said, there is a museum. And it is behind there. And from Salar Jung, you can walk there. I said, wah, let's go to that museum. And it was inside one of the Nizam school, the school that was founded by the Nizam. It was a private museum. And we walked, 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 and we walked. And we went to the museum, and we went to the gate. The gate was locked. Nobody was there. And we shouted, security! And the security came and said, what? Museum? And my friends knew Hindi, and they spoke to everybody and to the security guard and said, they've come to see the museum. Museum, correct. Come inside, said the security guard. And we went to the counter. And the counter was open just for us. And it was opened. And they said the ticket was, I think, about 100 rupees each, one person. We said, wow, main museum, 10 rupees, 20 rupees, 30 rupees, this private museum, 100 rupees, okay. And they said, you with the ticket, you get also a guide free. Guide. You see, we Indians love, no, buy one, get one free. 1 kilo tomato plus 1 kilo tomato, Amazon offer 1+1. We all love discount, no? Is there anybody who doesn't like discount and offers? And we were like, wow, we got a guide also. And the guide came from the top and said, come, I will show you the entire museum. And it is such a beautiful museum. And he said, okay, show the museum, we said. And they took us into the museum. He took us into the museum. And the museum was like, oh. And we went up and up and up. And the museum was a gift that all the rulers in the world, from Australia, from England, from Africa, from Europe, from South America, all the kings and queens had given to the Nizam for his 50th year. And it was all decorated. And me, who knew little bit of Hindi, you know who taught me Hindi first, my first Hindi teacher? You know who that was? Madhuri Dixit. And you all know that song that Madhuri Dixit taught a lot of us Hindi. It starts like this. 1, 2, yeah. 1, 2, 3, yeah. You want to sing that along with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, now 10, 11, 12, la 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 la. And I understood what he said. I thought I knew Hindi, my God, I've learned it. And we went inside and the guide said, oh, and he showed everything. And he's always saying, Sona, 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 Sona. And that alone stuck to my head. And that stuck to my head. I was like, wow. I was looking at everything and I, wow. And I thought I understood whatever he spoke. And my friends were also nodding and asking him questions. And everything got over and we came out. And when we came out, I asked my question to my friends. I kept this question in my heart. And I asked this question. And the question was, oh, all these gifts were made when the king was sleeping. And my friends looked at me and they said, Sona doesn't mean sleep. Sona has another meaning. Can you all tell me what is the other meaning for Sona? Anybody? What is the? Yeah, gold. All the time that the guide was telling that this is made of gold, that is made of gold, this is made of gold, I was thinking that it was made when somebody was sleeping. I thought the Nizam was sleeping, the sculptor was sleeping, the goldsmith, everybody was sleeping, and made the gift. The gift was statues, rings, medals, buildings, replicas. I thought, my God, everybody was sleeping and making this. And that day I said, whatever. I learned one more word in Hindi. And I'm still learning. And we all are learning every day, no? And especially as teachers, today we all, as students, know multiple languages. We all know so many languages. And it's always good to start learning a language anytime. And I will realize that any language is a lifelong journey. I can learn a language, even what I think is English and Tamil and a little bit of Kannada, I am still learning every day. And if somebody tells you, you don't know this language, tell them, I am learning it today. Because that's how beautiful our country is. India has such so many languages, and we can't learn every language. We can't even learn our own language beautifully, because each of our languages are Sundara Bhasha, Bangla, Gujarati, Marathi, Telugu, Malayalam. Now, can you all tell me what is your mother tongue or what is your father tongue? Because mother and father will speak different languages today. What language do you think is your language? And every day, that is so, Maithili, beautiful. Maithili is now recognized legally also. Beautiful. More powers to Maithili. Bangla, Gujarati, Punjabi. And every language is so beautiful that we can learn every day, today, tomorrow, the after. And that's how it is. Okay. That is how I learned this language. And my story went on. And a lot of us read books. And I also sometimes read books, but I tell the books, I tell stories from the books, and I love telling. And there's one particular rock star who was the Enid Blyton of India, who was the J.K. Rowling of India, who was the rock star writer of India. You know who I'm talking about? And he wrote in English, and he was not in America. He was not in, I'm saying, I'm using the word was, because Ruskin Bond is still there. I'm using the word was. Somebody who was then, he wrote for children. He was not in England. You know who that person was? And he had a long name, a name that went from Delhi to Chennai, from Ahmedabad to Kolkata. Itna bada naam hai. Ivlo periya per. Tum behezuru. Yare de. You know who that is? And he also, there was also a serial that was made in the 80s, which went like this. Tane ne tane tandane, tane ne tane tandane, tandane tane tandane, tana ne tane tandane. Yeah, it was R.K. Narayanan. And R.K. Narayanan is only a micro of the name, because his full name was Rasipuram Krishna Swami Narayana Swami. Rasipuram Krishna Swami Narayana Swami had three M's in his life. Yeah, three M's in his life. And the one of the three M was Madras, because he was born in Madras. And this story is about a story from the life of Rasipuram Krishna Swami Narayana Swami. And this was the little R.K. Narayanan that we all know. And the story is not about his book. The story is not about how he wrote. But I'm going to tell you the story, how this picture was taken in Madras. And in Madras, when he was born, what language do you think that he spoke? What was the language he spoke in Madras to everybody around him? Did he speak Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Kannada? What was the language do you think? Tamil or Tamar, as they say. And he didn't live with his papa and mama. He lived with his grandparents. And grandparents in Tamar is called Pati and Tata. This party, you know, if you take very shortly, instead of party, it becomes patti, it becomes dog in Malayalam, or yappa. And that is how India is, no? If you go north of India, you can't say chumma. And if you come to south of India, everybody says chumma, 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 chumma. Yeah, so confusing. So party is grandmother, and grandfather is tata, or tata with a H. And that is how it is. And Tata and Pati, he lived with, and every day he lived with them. But he also had two pets. he had two lovely pets. Yeah, he was a brother of R.K. Lakshman, and both of them were almost 10 to 12 years in different. They were very, had a very long age gap, that it was very interesting, their relationship. And they had a pet. Can you tell me what pets will people have? What pets do people have today? What pets do you think people have today? Come on, come on. What pets do you all like to have? And I will show you a pet that is there right around me slowly. Can you see? Yeah, cats, dogs. What pet do you think RK and Ayan grew up with? Did he grow up with a dog? Did he grow up with a cat? Did he grow up with parrots? Beautiful. So. Think. What pets? Give me as many pets that you think. Okay, monkey, okay. Turtle, okay, super. Hen. Cow, okay. And he lived with the two pets, which was a monkey, and the second pet was a peacock. Yeah. His party and Tata had a monkey and a peacock, and Rasipuram Krishna Swami, Narayana Swami, was a naughty fellow. And there was somebody in the house who was more naughty. You know who was that? It was the peacock. Yeah. You know what the peacock did? Whenever somebody came to the house and rang their bell, and the peacock used to go to the gate and ow, 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 and stand in the gate and spread its wings so that people don't come into the house. It used to have this big wing. And whenever people came into the house, the peacock used to do like a tandavam, Rudra tandavam. And nobody could come into the house without saying hi to the peacock. And R.K. Narayan was like, I'm the father monkey. And the monkey was smiling all the time. And the peacock was like protecting. The peacock thought it was a dog. The monkey thought it was a cat. And the peacock was always guarding the gate. And whenever somebody came, it used to run around the gate and come back and say, I'm the monkey. Instead of doing meow, it said, and it was something like that. And everybody was like, my God, Stoon. I thought children were naughty and these two animals are naughty. And that's the beauty of children, because they have to be naughty, because if they're not naughty, there's something in their heart. And these two monkeys and peacock and R.K. Narayan were like, and when R.K. Narayan was with Tata party, R.K. Lakshman was not even born. And R.K. Narayanan, monkey, and R.K. Narayanan also had a pet name. Do any of you have pet names in your house? You don't have to tell us, but did you have, tell me yes or a no, especially those names which only Papa, Mama, or Dada, Dadi, or Nana, Nani will call us, and we won't tell it outside, that cute little name. And you know what R.K. Narayanan was called? Kunjappa. Yes, Kunjappa. And Kunja, and every time R.K. Narayanan heard Kunjappa, he said, my name is Narayanan, not Kunjappa. And his macro name, Rasipuram Krishna Swami Narayanan, became so small. And that's what happened. And Rasipuram Krishna, R.K. Narayanan, one day was waiting. But he was waiting for his mama. Yes, mama in Hindi, mama in Tamil, mama in many language means mama's brother. And he was waiting for his mama, because mama loved to take photographs. Yeah, R.K. Narayanan's mama was one of the first photographers of India. And he used to take fabulous photos, and his photos were like, and those days, this is 1920s, were they small cameras or big cameras? You can't take selfies like this, right? Because the camera itself will be so big. And that is how Rasipuram Krishna Swami Narayana Swami was very naughty. And I'm going to show you one naughty friend. You see, my naughty friend. And that peacock and the monkey were so naughty. And one day he was waiting for uncle to come. And uncle came home, took a big camera and put it in front and said, Krishna Swami Narayana Swami, come and sit here. And... but he said, call that monkey. What is monkey called in your mother tongue? Can you all tell me what is monkey called in your languages? Monkey called in whatever languages you speak. What is monkey called in your language? Bandar. Tashimano. And that's beautiful. And R.K. Narayan was waiting for this photo to be taken. But uncle said, call the monkey, call the peacock. And this peacock is very naughty. You know what the peacock did? When somebody didn't say hello to the peacock will fly, 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 and hit them on the head. You know how? So you better say hello to the peacock. Can you all say hi to the peacock? Say hello. Hello. Hi. If you don't say hi, the peacock will come into scratching on the head like a head massage. And Mamaji said hello to the peacock. And the peacock came. And you see how peacocks will sit. And the monkey was sitting. And the monkey sat. And the peacock sat. And both of them were like sitting next. And naughty R.K. Narayan was sitting on the chair. And uncle put this camera. And you know how long does it take? Can you all guess how long will it take to take one photograph? Today we can take a selfie in 1 second, 3 seconds, half a second. But those days for one photograph, how much time do you think it'll take? 1 minute or 2 minutes or 10 minutes or half an hour? Can you guess how long it'll take? Anybody? How long do you think it'll take? Half an hour, yeah. So 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes, 28 minutes, 29 minutes. And uncle said, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And action! And when uncle finished taking the photograph, Narayan was so waiting for the photograph to come. And when the photograph came, you know what happened? And this is what happened. Do you see the monkey or the peacock in the photo? Yes, no, maybe. Yeah, the monkey and the peacock went out of frame. They went tata, bye bye. And they didn't come in the photo. But then, this is one of the first photographs that was taken of R.K. Narayanan by his Mamaji in Madras. Later, R.K. Narayan from Madras went to Mysore, and then he wrote Malgudi Days. And then we all know his Malgudi Days. But he still remembers the first photo, how he wanted to take with the peacock and the monkey, and both of them didn't come in frame. There was no Photoshop. There was no Instagram. There was no filter. So he couldn't add them into the picture. But then this is the first photograph that of the youngest rock star writer, Indian writer, that across the world we know. For some of us who might have seen Hindi movies, you might remember Guide, which Devanand and Vahida Rehman acted, and that comes from his book, and so on and so forth, many stories of R.K. Narayanan. And today, we, as much as we look at foreign authors, there's so many Indian authors who are doing fabulous job, and this man wrote many years back when we didn't have Google, we didn't have internet. He wrote because he loved to write. And he loved to write. And if you see anybody who loves to do what they are doing, let them love it and do it. Maybe there'll be an there is an R.K. Narayan in there is a Leander Pace, there is a Saina Nehwal, there is a rock star in the children right next to you. And that is your second story of this little rock star. So this is the picture. And let me show that again. So this was taken by his uncle T in Sheshachalam. I mean, this is from his autobiography. This is a photo from his autobiography. And you will see that how he's nicely sitting. He's a quiet boy and posing. Today, can we all pose like that? Can you all freeze for 30 minutes? Okay. So from here, I'm going to take you to another world of a very short story of stories of something that we all look at. So we have so many different people that people pray to in India. There is Allah, Jesus, Krishna, Rama. There's a guru. People go to Gurudwara, temple, churches, and so many places. And there is one more person that somebody prays to. And this person's name starts with B. Do you know that person? Goddesses, of course, Shakti, there is Saraswati, Parvati, Sheetala Devi, there is Mariamma, Yellamma. And there is temples for different people, there's worship space for different people. But there is one person that people pray to, and his name is starts with B. And the moment people think meditation, we think of that person whose name starts with B. Do you know who I'm talking about? This person was a king who became a prophet, who became a saint. You know who I'm talking about? Yeah, Buddha. This is a small tale from Buddha's. This is a folklore, so don't think so much. So once upon a time, Buddha went out and wanted to sit and just meditate. And he was about to meditate and he sat down to meditate. You see how difficult it is to meditate. It's like how Arkanan had to sit for taking a photo. Today's meditation, what could today's meditation be? It can be Zoom classes, sitting and watching a Zoom class or listening to a Zoom class where the teacher or the student, I mean, the teacher will be going on and we'll be like, And for the teachers, listening to other teachers or another workshop. And today Zoom is like the meditation, you know, whenever you have to like be like a frame. And that's how Buddha wanted to meditate. He wanted to meditate and sit back and he wanted to relax. And Buddha realized that one of the ahankara that we all have, which we all give away to reduce the ahankara or ego, that we, and whenever we see a mirror, we do something with that. You know, what is that? Whenever you see a mirror, we take a comb and do something. You know what we do? What is that which we immediately do something with that? You know, what is that? Style. But what do we style? Do we style a hand? Do we style a... Yeah, the hat style. And there is mushroom cut, capsicum cut, porcupine cut, this cut, that cut, straight cut, long cut, and everything with the hair. Imagine if the hair is not there. Will you ever go to the mirror? And Buddha said, I'm going to give away the hair. Because the hair is like, I so much of a hair. It's like, I have to take moments and I'm taking care of it. Every day I have to wash it with oil, I have to comb it, I have to take care of it. I don't want the hair. And one day Buddha gave away the hair. And Buddha gave away the hair. And you know what is the English word when you people take away their hair called? It's called tonsuring. So Ani like took away the hair. And full tonsure. Yeah. And took away the head, so no half cut, full cut, two side, one side, and took away the and tonsured the head, so that it is like smooth football ground, and what we call palapala in the South Indian language, full shining, 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 and he did it, and he said, "I wanted to meditate," and he went and sat in a meditation pose, and he sat, and he started meditating because he wanted, and he started meditating that he forgot he started to meditate early in the morning. He started meditating early in the morning. What time do you think Buddha woke up? What time do you... I'm not going to ask you what time you woke up because sometimes if we today Zoom, no? So even if there is a class at 9 o'clock, we wake up at 8:59 and then sit and then we will just put on the shirt and say, good morning. But this is Buddha. What time do you think Buddha woke up? 3 to 5? Brahma Muhurtam. Yeah, he woke up, let's say 3 to 5 and he sat down to meditate. And 3 to 4 to 4 to 5 to 5 to 6 to 6 to 7 to 7 to 8 to 8 to 9 and 9 to 10, 10. And as the time went on, and you see, India is a very diverse climatic condition, but wherever the climatic condition is, will the sun get intense or cooler? So did the sun get cooler or hotter? What do you think happened to the sun? Was it getting hot, or was it getting cold? And it's getting hotter and hotter and hotter and hotter. And by the time it was 1 o'clock, Buddha's head was like, full frying was happening. And Buddha's head was frying. And everybody was looking, waiting for to see Buddha's head crack. Because they had never seen somebody meditating without opening their eyes. And everybody was crowding. All the animals were crowding, all the humans were crowding, all the birds were crowding, and everybody was seeing where was Buddha's meditation going. And it went and went and went and went and went. But should you watch or should you help? Should you wait for the head to crack or should you help the Buddha? What do you think you should do? Help, right? And sometimes the help comes from the least expected people, not somebody even we think will help us. And the people didn't come forward. The dogs didn't come forward. The cats didn't come forward. The eagles didn't come forward. The peacock didn't come forward. The monkey didn't come forward. And the ants also didn't come forward. Nobody came forward. But there was one being which we never ever see, because this animal is very slow, very slimy, and very yucky to a lot of people. And this animal is like slowly walking at 0.00001 kilometers per second or meters per hour. And this, yeah, like the sloth, it was the snail. And we all have a word for snail in our language. Sometimes we forget English words in a mother tongue, father tongue. And the snail was watching, and it looked right, it looked left, and it said, nobody is going. The dogs are just watching. The dogs are watching. And see, the dog is watching like this. And the cats are watching and nobody's helping. The trees are also watching. The plants are watching. The roses are watching. The lilies are watching. And the, only the donda, thanks Rashmi for that. And the donda went and said, why is nobody helping? Maybe I should help, because I have something to cool the head. And you see the snail? Below the snail, it's very slippery and very slimy, and it said, maybe I could go up. And it started climbing Buddha's head. It went up and up and up and up and up and up. And went up. And one snail stuck and cooled down Buddha's head. And one snail went up. Two snails went up. When two snails went up, it became three, it became five, it became 10 and 15 and 20 and 25 and 30 and 35, 40, 45, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. No, after they'd grown so much, it stopped at a magical number. You know what's a magical number? It's 100 and something. That's there in many, many cultures. Yeah, the 108. So there were 108 snails which went up to Buddha and covered his head. And when it covered its head, Buddha's head. Can you see this baby? Can you see Buddha? Can you see it closer? And Buddha's head was covered by the snail. It was covered beautifully by the snail. And the snail covered Buddha so beautifully so that Buddha could get even the warmth, and the snail started cooling Buddha. And if this Buddha you may have not seen, you must have seen the other Buddha statue across India. And if you see this and see a little bit closer, you will see these lovely creatures, which is there in every place. It's there in the farmland. It'll be there in lots of places, but because it's very slow, we don't look down. And this went up and covered Buddha's head. And that is how they say Buddha got the head full of snails. But this is one version. There is multiple other versions. But that's how stories are. You tell the version, but you tell why you're telling this version. And like the snail, we're all like the snail, right? Nobody's going to look at us and say that we are the fastest. You are the brilliant. No, we are all like the snail, because like the snail has its own little house. We're all comfortable and we all believe in ourselves. We all know our strengths. And like the snail, when there is a time, we can help anybody. We should help somebody whom we think we can help. And that's the snail head of Buddha. And snail, there are many stories of snails, but this story is a story how the snails got together and covered the entire head and gave tanda tanda cool cool to Buddha itself. Because snails said, oh, Buddha's head is cracking. And that's how it happened. And from there, I'm going to take you to another story of this Buddha or somebody like him that children today look up to. So there is one personality that everybody or children look up to today, like the Buddha, who's an inspiration. This person is also has a long hair, and he's no longer there, but he's an inspiration to a lot of children. You know who that is? And this man went from the south of India into the Delhi's Rashtrapati Bhavan. You know who this man is? Yeah, Abdul Kalam. I'm going to just shift this power cut. Give me a second. I'm just going to shift the space. And Abdul Kalam was his name. Yeah. And Abdul Kalam, the rock star Abdul Kalam, was such a rock star that people loved him. And Abdul Kalam ji was the president. And today, where Abdul Kalam was born, you will see that his house is a little memorial. And you all know, where was Abdul Kalam born? Which city was he? Did he born in Delhi, Bombay, Coimbatore? Where do you think Abdul Kalam was born? Which city? It's there in your textbook. It's there everywhere. It's Wikipedia will tell you. Where was? Not Madurai. La 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 Coimbatore. Okay. Yeah, something like that. Go. Yeah, Tamil Nadu. City. Gandhi Nagar. Okay. Yeah, Rameshwaram. And born in Rameshwaram, this man, before he went to Rashtrapati Bhavan, he also was a scientist, right? So when you look at the scientist, man, we say, okay, you're so busy, right? He was so busy. And one day he was a very busy scientist. And when this busy scientist was walking in the compound wall of his office, he was looking around and when he was looking around, he's noticed something. And when he noticed this, he saw a little closer. And when he looked a little closer, he found that something was there in the wall. And okay, have you all seen this type of a wall where it is covered by glasses on the top so that thieves don't come? Yes, no, maybe. Have you all seen this sort of a glass? Yeah, and when Abdul Kalam saw this, he got extremely angry. Yeah, Bharat Ratna Abdul Kalam got very, 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 very angry. He said, I don't want these glasses in my office. And all the securities said, why, sir? Why? What is the problem? What happened? Is it okay? And Abdul Kalam said, you don't know what the problem is? See closer. Look very closely. And in his own voice, he said, officers, look closely. Look very closely. And they said, okay, but what is with this glass? We don't see a problem. It is there for so many years. And he said, that is the problem. You're all being used to a system. You don't think about the system. And you know what Abdul Kalam said? If you see, there are so many birds around, no? And have you all seen birds come and sit on walls? Yes, no, maybe. And what will happen to the birds which sit on this wall, on the glass? Asked Abdul Kalam. My office should be a safe space for everybody. And even if one bird gets hurt because of this glass, that's not okay. That's not okay. And the bird should come and sit happily on my wall. And that is what I want. And he said, all the officers to remove the glasses on the wall. And the officers looked at him and said, wow, what a man. Yes, he was a scientist. Yes, he was the president. But he also paused for humanity. And he said, not a single bird should get hurt. Find other ways. Don't hurt a bird. And even now, if you go to Bangalore, if you go around the DRDO, you will find, because they're all secured area, So the glasses might not be there today, and ISRO, DRDO, the whole security, that one of the person who was in, was pioneer in removing the glasses on the world was APJ Abdul Kalam. And I know there are also a lot of children, so some of the stories I'm doing is a little performative because I want the children and the adults to connect to the story. And this story, okay, is somebody said Panchatantra. Yes, I'm going to tell you a story from Panchatantra, which is Panchatantra was not written and Hitopadesh was not written, they were recited. So there is a difference between a written story and an oral story. So once upon a time, there was a huge group of birds, Pakshigal. And these birds were like roaming everywhere. They were flying and flying and flying and flying and flying. And the birds had a queen bird. And this queen bird was the boss bird. Can you all tell me a bird's name? Quickly, can you all give me a bird's name? Everybody, we all know birds, right? I'm saying, give me bird's name. Except parrot, pigeon, crow, eagle. Give me other bird's name. India has so many birds. Cuckoo, parrot, think of other birds because we have almost 60 to 70% of the world's population. Hummingbirds, parrot, beautiful. Duck, nice. Hen, lovely. Beautiful. Bulbul. And there were so many birds, and the queen mother was the queen of all the birds. The queen mother was the queen of all the birds. I'm saying every day, all the birds have to get divided into four parts. One bird, one fourth has to go north, one fourth has to go east and west and south. And they had to go and get food for everybody. And everybody had to go and get everybody's food. And all the birds went everywhere. They went north, they went west, they went east, and they went. And the sparrow also went. And one day the sparrow went to a direction, and the sparrow saw a big cart of rice. A big cart of rice. And the sparrow said,
Should I keep it with me? Should I keep it a secret? Or should I go and tell to the queen? Should I keep it? And what do you think that the sparrow did? Did the sparrow keep it a secret? Or did the sparrow keep it?
Tell it to the queen. And the sparrow kept it a secret. And every day the sparrow kept a secret and didn't give it to anybody. And every day the sparrow went and went and went and went and went and told the queen, there is no food, queen, there is empty room. I kept it a secret. But what did the sparrow do? Open its mouth. And the moment it kept it a secret, will the sparrow smile more or have a very face? Face or smiling face? Smiling face or face, straight face? Because it didn't tell the secret to anybody. What do you think? It was smiling as if your grumpy face because it said, no. Poker face, exactly, poker face. That kind of face. And everybody saw that the sparrow stopped talking to everybody. And the sparrow's tummy was growing from small size to medium size to triple XL size, this big size. And the sparrows was still. And everybody knew there was something wrong with the sparrow. And the sparrow one day had such a big tummy that the sparrow got a tummy ache. But the sparrow still kept a poker face. And the friends, if the sparrow doesn't share the secret, will the sparrow have less friends or more friends? What do you think? Less friends or more friends? Sparrow, less. And the sparrow who had 100 friends, from the hen to the peafowl to the parrot to the crow, from 190, 80, 70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, almost zero. And the sparrow still was keeping poker face. And all the birds had a meeting. And they said, we all are struggling to get food, but this sparrow's tummy is triple XL size, this big.
And he's saying that there is no food. The sparrow is not telling the truth. And let us go talk to the parrot. Let us go talk to the kingfisher. Let's go talk to the pigeon.
And they all went and said, okay, let's go and talk to the let's talk to the sparrow. Yeah. And that night, when everybody was sleeping, all the birds went and the sparrow was sleeping. And they went and woke up the sparrow. Do you all like to get woken up in your sleep? Yes, no? Do you like to be woken up in your sleep? Deep sleep. Yes, no? Yeah. And that's the sparrow also the same thing, no? And they went and said, sparrow! And the sparrow woke up. You can also do that along with me. Put your hand out and stretch it like. And the sparrow started like talking. And they all said, shh, sparrow, why are you agitated? And the sparrow, I have tummy ache. And they all said, of course, because your tummy is full of your secret rice. And the sparrow said, how do you know? Look at your tummy size. It has grown so big because you're eating without telling us. And the sparrow said, yeah, but what should I do? I found it. I will only keep it. If you find something, should you keep it or should you share it? What will you all do? If you find something that you all like, it could be even gold. It could be even pencil. It could be a good book. It could be a good YouTube video. What will you do? Yeah, and they said, sparrow, you just have to share. Because is it okay to eat only rice every day? Can you only eat one thing every day? Can you eat only chapati every day? Can you only eat mangoes every day? Can you only eat tomatoes every day? Can you only eat, let's say even pizzas and burgers every day? You need variety. That is how you'll be healthy. And the sparrow said, oh, really? Yeah. You get rice. We get tomato. Somebody gets potato. Somebody gets capsicum. We'll put together and make sambar. We'll make dal and we'll enjoy. Yeah. And the sparrow says, so I should share now. What do you think? Yeah, you should share. And the sparrow then said where it was getting its rice. The moment the sparrow shared, the stomachache went away. And they all came and gave a hug to the sparrow. And they said, see, if you share, it will go away. And the moment you share, we all will eat healthily. And that's what the sparrow understood. Oh, really? Okay, from today I will share, said the sparrow. And they all hugged each other. If your children are next to you, or if you with yourself, hug yourself. Because today we need people to share much more than any other day. And make sure that you're sharing your deepest feeling. Because they say, anyone who can listen is a great doctor. So be listen to your friends. And because a lot of us might not even share, but if you see somebody who is with a heavy heart, go and share with them. And that's what's humane. That's what makes a human being, right? And I'll end with one last story and then we'll open to question and answers. And this story is a folk tale come from a community called the Kurathi Korava community in Tamil Nadu. I hope some of you might know the tribal communities. So this story is about once a Kurathi, a tribal lady was walking, and she saw a man who was crying in pain. And she said, what has happened to you? Stomachache, or what in English called stomachache. You see, English is a very funny language, no? P-U-T, put B-U-T, but. And he said, I have worms in my tummy. this is a Tamil folktale, so I'm making it into English. And she said, very simple problem. I just solved this problem and kid. And he said, what? How do you solve it? And she said, very simple. Go and get a chicken, okay? And can you all take the chicken? Yeah, take the chicken. And put masala on the head. And eat the chicken. And when you eat the chicken will go inside and will eat all the worms, will eat all the insects, all everything in the tummy, and will be better. And he said, how will the chicken come out? How will it come out? Oh, that, you just have to burp. Can you burp? And he said, and that is how the chicken will come out. And he said, what? And moment he said, and burped, his stomach was okay. It was perfect. It was fantastically okay. And she said, that's all. Sometimes what we think is something inside us, it needs something called the shock treatment. You know the shock treatment that our grandparents used to say is, that is all we need. And that's how she cured the man's stomach ache. And she went away. And that's your stories for today. Love everybody, because today we're all virtually connected. So love to listen, share stories, and fly, because we're all lovely human beings. Thank you, and open to questions, and however we want to take questions. Let's do that.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Vikram. I think you can see the chat messages pouring in from the participants. It was amazing. Thank you. Participants, now it's open for some questions. Kindly share the questions in the chat box. And Vikram, I think there is a lot of people asking for your contact details, like mobile number and email ID. If you wish, you can share that in the chat box.
Yeah, I can put in the chat. And some of you can also follow on Instagram. I mean, I'm socially there. Is it okay to put the contact, or should I give it to you,
sir? Yeah. No, it's fine. You can put it. That's perfectly fine.
Any particular question that somebody wants to ask, just raise your hand and... you can unmute them and they can ask.
Yes. So kindly raise your hand if you have any questions. I can unmute you. And then, so there is a question from Ms. Rekha Kaur. I will just allow her to talk. So Ms. Rekha Kaur, now you can speak. Next one is, yes, Prabhavati. And the next one is Renuka. We will take very few questions. Ms. Rekha Kaur, kindly unmute yourself and then you can speak. You can ask your question. Okay, so Srika, are you there? Okay, so now I'm going to allow Ms. Renu Gurk. Ms. Renu, you can unmute yourself and then ask your question.
Yes, sir. I like this session. I am asking, next session, when will be?
No comments. We just want questions, specific questions, participants. If you have questions, kindly raise your hand. Otherwise, you can... Okay, so I'm going to allow Ms. Prabhavati. Prabhavati, please. Kindly unmute yourself and then you can speak. And then I'm going to allow Ms. Uma Narain. Ms. Uma Narain, I have allowed you to ask a question.
Hello, sir. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I initially missed a little bit of a few minutes of storytelling, but I had a great listening for the last few minutes. It was really great. Thank you so much for this opportunity. Just one question from my side, sir. These days...
So you have been...
Am I audible?
Yes. Please go ahead. Kindly do not unmute.
Who are asking the stories from their parents and grandparents is hugely reduced. They are going back with the YouTube channel and watching the mobile phones all the times and sleeping, even when they go to bed as well. Before they go to bed, they are watching the phone and they are listening to stories from the such gadgets, not exactly listening from the parents. So the kind of a voice modulation you gave, you brought in the real picture in front of us, actually. Right. That way it cannot be given by all the parents. But I always feel that any story that you listen from your grandparents and parents, it's always in your mind. But this trend is reduced largely. So what do you think we can do it? Maybe everyone is busy with their work life and household chores, and we miss this culture. But how do we bring this back? Any suggestions from you?
So it is not even stories.
Sorry for that large question.
No. So it's not about stories also. It's also about singing, dancing. A lot of it we have stopped doing at home. No? Because if you look at our previous generation, we used to sing together. We used to dance together, tell stories together. Slowly dancing went away to the dance teacher. Singing went away to the singing teacher. Then men stopped dancing and singing because men don't. But men are very conscious. Then the women had to only do storytelling. And now that has also gone away because we have gadgets in between. So it's not even about storytelling. I think everything should come back home because that's the strength of a family. And artists will always be there. There will be home art and there will be public art. I'm saying it starts at home. And then people like us are more professional and more, we only do this. So there is both. So the parents are the first artists that the child should definitely connect. And if it's like saying that if you want to tell stories and child to listen, you should put the gadget away for some time. A child will connect what they see with the parent. A parent is the first. So if you read a book, the child will read a book. If you listen to the child's story, the child will listen to your story. If we don't listen to the child's story, they won't listen. And for some of you who ask questions, one is you will see that I've not used any props or thing because that is puppetry and that is a different genre of storytelling. There is a genre of storytelling which, like what I'm doing. There is nothing you need to tell a story. Just the voice. And we are the greatest thing. And second, if anybody wants to have a session, just, I've written my email ID. Just can connect with me on Insta or my email ID or ask Vignesh sir, then definitely we'd love to. Because this is all I do. I mean, I'm a big shoe. I only tell stories for a living. So any space.
Sure. So there are a few questions around, is there any good platform where they can get good stories which they can share it with their school children or their parents?
There's a library called Mama and Papa, which is the first library that I believe in. The second is your own library. Something all books can be told as stories because books are reading is one habit. Telling them is another habit. Reading is completely different world. Writing is a different world, but the same thing can be told. So even, and you can also make up your stories. Remember those days when we used to sit and say, you'll see a fan and make a story out of the fan. So it just get into that creative world. I'm saying then that's all. Because, and there are lots of books. I'm saying start with vernacular, start with your mother tongue, father tongue. English is always there. There are numerous sources. Today online is abundant. But
I think there are a few people who wanted to ask. Ms. Ramya Gupta, do you have a question? Okay, I think it's okay. So there is a question around like how do we choose the stories for the target audience?
So it's not about the story, it's about what do you do with the story. Every story can be told to a child, a teen and an adult. What do you do with that story? For a only thing different between a child and an adult is a child friendly story can be told to an adult. An adult friendly story might not be applicable to a child. For example, marital relationship. And that could, and even in terms of relationship, the child has to cross puberty. That is when child thing. So keep that in mind. And any story, the same, all stories I told today can be told to a 1 year old child and a 90 year old silver talkie. When I say silver, it means people. Seen the world. So same story can work with any age.
Oh, sorry, I forgot to unmute. So there is a question about I need to learn these voice modulation. Can you give few tips?
Um, it's I mean, it's like singing and dancing. It's like Sarigama Padanisa. I mean, it does take a lot of training, because when I do voice, I mean, I will not strain it after 1 hour of talking. But you be careful. But what you can do is, when you're talking, use your hand. When you use your hand, it's a little more easy to talk easily. That itself will help you to modulate. The moment you hold your hand and talk, you might not be able to use it very freely. So don't control your hand. Let your hand flow.
Sure, sure. So my daughter also wants to see you and say hi. Say hi.
Hi.
Hi. Balagopal sir.
Yes. It was amazing and wonderful. I am grateful to Dr. Mr. Vikram Sridhar for such an amazing performance. It was nice, and you have captured the minds of the children and the parents, and you can communicate a lot of things through these storytelling sessions. Thank you, Dr. Mr. Vikram Sridhar, and keep it up.
Thank you.
So thank you so much, Vikram. I think I think there are a few questions. They wanted your YouTube channel URL, your email ID. I think you have shared already. So one more time, if you can share, that would be wonderful. And with this, we would like to thank Vikram for taking out time and being with us. Yeah, I'm coming. Wait. She wants me to go with her.
Your time, your story time.
Yeah. So thank you so much, Vikram and Balagopal sir, for participating, and to all the participants who are here. We will share the feedback link. I have a couple of housekeeping announcement also. So thank you so much, Vikram, and to all the participants.
Thank you to all of you for sharing your time. I mean, my email ID is there. I mean, just search on Google. I'm there on Facebook, Instagram, anywhere. Just there's something that I can come and do for all of you. Let me know. Thank you. Have a good day. Dhanyavadagalu, Nandri, Nanni. Namaste.
So thank you everyone. I'm just sharing the feedback form URL. So before that, I'm just sharing the registration URL. First, you need to register yourself for the session, and then you can submit your feedback form. Once you submit the feedback form, immediately below that you can download the certificate of participation. So that is how it works. And I have just, for YouTube viewers, I will put it in the chat box very shortly. So kindly bear with us for a few minutes. And tomorrow's session is on new age digital learning techniques. It's between 6:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. And I'm sharing the feedback form URL in the chat box. And also, you can view all our upcoming URLs, webinars from the URL mentioned in the chat box. And we will kindly request you to install the NDLA mobile app from our official Play Store or iStore. I'm just putting it in the chat box. And also, there is a CADES is providing skills for work scholarship for people who are interested in pursuing more courses, lifelong courses. So kindly take benefit of it. And with this, we are going to end this session. I'm just going to put the URLs in the chat box again. All the URLs, so kindly take note of it.